Tonight in eastern Kentucky, a desperate search for survivors continues as the catastrophic flooding that killed at least 37 people is still being reckoned with. Look at all the damage. People's lives scattered everywhere. The governor says he is seeing the best of people as they rise from the brutal force of nature that destroyed homes and ruined so many lives. He said despite it all, he's never witnessed such perseverance. Still, thousands of people are in desperate need of aid. Yesterday, two UNC Chapel Hill residents stepped in with some help from above. WRO's Eric Miller joins us live with that story. Eric?
Well, Gerald, it really is remarkable what these two were able to put together in just over a day, an impromptu airlift from the Carolinas to Kentucky.
For Randy Barnett, the first sign something was wrong was a text.
From my best friend in Kentucky, asking if my family was okay. I tried to get a hold of my parents, my sister, couldn't get a hold of anyone.
After hours of worry, she found out why. Images like this filling her screen. Her father on a rescue boat, water in every direction, cars tossed like toys, houses drowned, including her family's house.
Everyone up my holler lost their homes. My whole community was destroyed. And so all I wanted to do was get back home. And I'm being told that there's no physical way for me to get there.
No way, until Sunday night, when she happened to be working with another resident named Philip Scholes.
I cannot tell you how much of a hero he is.
That's what I felt compelled to do.
Scholes is a licensed pilot and former Navy flight surgeon. In just over 24 hours, he tracked down a plane, mapped out a route, and was able to take Barnett where roads no longer could.
And I was like, oh, this is real. Like, he actually wants to do this.
Scholes and Barnett loaded the plane with clothes, shoes, water, and more for those in need.
I think we maxed out about 350 pounds of supplies that we were able to take.
By Tuesday afternoon, they were landing in Hazard, Kentucky, meeting a ground crew full of familiar faces.
I have my mom, my sister, my brother-in-law, and my aunt and uncle. It's a lot different seeing them in person than just hearing their voices on a phone. So that really meant a lot to me.
A day later, Scholes and Barnett are back to work at UNC. Barnett hoping their help from above meant something to the people stuck below.
I really hope that what we did, you know, sends a message to tell people, hey, like, there's so many people out here that care about you.
And Barnett's not stopping there. She's planning to go back to eastern Kentucky in a couple of weeks, planning to go back home and bring more supplies. Obviously, one person carrying stuff back and forth from the Carolinas to Kentucky, that's not going to be able to solve this crisis. So she's encouraging people to donate to Team Eastern Kentucky Flood Relief or Aspire Appalachia. Gerald?
Amazing what two people can accomplish when they're determined and they put their minds together. Thank you, Eric.